Do we pay our kids an allowance? Do we just expect them to do their chores? To pay or not to pay? That's the question we'll look at today. Kids an allowance. We recently moved back to the States from Southeast Asia, and here we're in the process of setting up a homestead. These are very different locations, very different lifestyles, and they give very different responsibilities for the boys. This has caused us to relook at our system of allowance versus expectation. We feel like we need to balance the two. There are plenty of things that we expect from the boys because they live here and because they're part of the family. However, we want to balance that with teaching them a work ethic, and that if you work hard, you get paid, and if you don't work hard, you don't get paid. So this is the answer that our family came up with. First, there are plenty of things that we expect the boys to do simply because they're part of the family. They are responsible for feeding the animals. At this point, it's kind of easy because we don't have many. But every morning when they get up, they go outside and feed the cats and the dog. And Stefan insisted on getting a bunny, so he gets to feed the bunny. Also, it's currently winter time and it's cold, and we only have a wood heater in our house, so every day they carry wood to the house. This will happen all winter and whenever mommy gets cold. In the summer, they're responsible for hanging laundry on the line. They're also responsible for helping me weed the garden. And as the homestead grows and we get more animals and we put up fences, these are all things that the boys will be expected to do because we live on a homestead and because that's the life that we chose. So all of these types of chores are just expectations for them. And now that we've covered those, let's talk about the things that we do pay them for. The boys receive a base pay or base allowance of $10 a week. This has been a fluid number for us. When we started and the boys were young, about 5 and 7, they got about $3 a week, and they didn't really have to do that much. We moved that to $5 a week a couple years later, and now that they're 11 and 13, we changed it to 10. A couple of reasons for that. One, we live pretty remotely, so they don't have a chance to go find someone in town where they can mow lawns or do chores or run errands. Two, we expect at least double from them as we did last time we did this sheet. So that's the reason why that may seem high. In their list of chores, they have daily chores, chores they do every other day, and chores they do once a week. Each of those chores is assigned a dollar amount. For example, they do dishes every other day. Every time they wash dishes, that's a dollar. It doesn't mean they earn a dollar for getting dishes done. It means if they don't do dishes, I subtract a dollar from that 10. Because the next boy has to do dishes the next day, this is an unforgiving chore. So if they don't do it, they're woken up early the next morning to get it done before the day starts, so their brother doesn't have to do those chores. Another example that they do daily is picking up their dirty laundry. If I find any piece of clothing, it's 10 cents per article that they owe me. If they don't pick up their toys or books, that's a quarter. So this is what they do every day, or with dishes every other day. And with dishes, they also have to wipe off the counter for 50 cents and wipe off the stove for another 50 cents. So if they don't do their dishes in that, they could lose $2 per time. They have to sweep twice a week. Every time they sweep their rooms that they're assigned, that's a dollar a time. So if they skip it, that's another dollar out of their 10. So by the end of the week, it could happen that they owe us money. It hasn't happened, but the possibility is there. So that's their base pay of $10. They also have a list of extra chores that they could do to earn money. It has happened that Stefan actually was the one working for something and he did a ton of extra chores because he had a goal in mind that he wanted. But we do have a list of extra chores they can do throughout the week to earn money. That includes washing the laundry. That's 50 cents a load. If they dry the laundry, it's 50 cents a load. if they fold the laundry, it's $1 a load. They could wash the vehicle for $7. That one has never happened. And there's also a spot that says other, where if they ask us to do work or if we have special work that we need done that week, we can say, hey, do you need or do you want extra money and you can do this. This has happened recently when I bought jars and they needed to be pre-washed. I gave both of them the chance to earn money by washing them for me. Michael took me up on it. But all of those are added in each week, and we keep track of it on this chart so that at the end of the week, we have a list of the things they've done or where they owe us money, and then any extra. At the end of the week, we put the total earned. We take out 10% for tithing, 10% for saving, and then the rest goes into their spending jar. And with the money in their spending jar, that's what they get to do. Spend it, if they so choose. This has a couple times caused heartache for us because we've watched them buy stuff that we just don't think is worth the money. But they have to learn that they worked for it so they can do it, and it hurts to spend money sometimes. So as I've said, this is our family's answer to the allowance question. I'm going to do a shout out to my sister-in-law who I stole the idea from and tweaked it for our family, and want to just make it very clear that this is what our family does and it works for us. Feel free to tweak it for your family or do something altogether different. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if so, please like and subscribe, leave a comment. Have a great day. Thanks.